Well, basically, in the early days, it was just five really good friends, you know, playing music, playing our music that we'd written. Some of it was pretty bad, and some of it was pretty good. And the memories are what everybody's memories are, of like good friends being in a gang together. You know, we used to travel around the country playing the clubs. Then it started to get pretty serious because our songs got better. And we started getting a pretty big following. We had what we called demo tapes, which we made and took down to the studios. And a couple of record companies like showed a little bit of interest. And those people who showed a little bit of interest, as soon as the songs got better, decided to sign us. And that's how it came along. And then along came the album. But we'd been waiting for the big break with the album for a long time, 4 or 5 years.
In the sound system we're using 20,000 watts, which is enough to blow the back wall out of this building. But that doesn't include the backline gear for the guitars and the speakers on the side here for the monitors for the band to hear themselves singing.
The volume goes with the music, you know, the aggression and the energy. I mean, you gotta think that when kids play our albums, they play them loud as well.
They're one of the better bands that have come up in the last 5 years in the new wave of British heavy metal. Better some of the dross that has come up.
It's just full of energy, isn't it? You know, something you can get into.
Well, there's that real cult following. You get people coming up and they've got, like, somehow they've got a French pressing of a Saxon album that's got the tracks in a different order. And, you know, there's like real fanaticism about regalia and everything to do with sex.
What a win, earn a living, eh?
Do you expect people to be, you know, fainting and passing out with the heat? And
it hasn't happened yet, but I can see it happening tonight.
It's
a big crowd in tonight.
It's a big crowd, a lot of kids in.
Does it ever get at all violent, or is it just good nature?
No, it's just good nature mainly.
You should know this one. This one's called Never Surrender. Come on!
We'll be right back. ago. Used to bring the mail to me through the ice and snow. I sat alone and watched her stealing through the night. 90 tons of thunder lighting up the sky. The princess of the night.
Don't tell him about the pedals, Steve.
Well, this is a new toy for me. It's the first time I've used them. Basically, because
first time he's abused them.
Yeah. Because on this new album, Power and the Glory, we do a track that starts with these. Quick demo. It goes like this. This is the intro to the number. And then the bass guitar comes in like this.
Come on! Balcony! You're looking at me! about Nottingham, okay? This one's called Does This Town Know How to Rock?
Yeah, I've always been a show-off, yeah. And that's what my job is, to be a show-off. Yeah, I've always been, you know, the one who always wants the attention. But all the other guys are the same anyway. I think that's probably why we do so well, because everybody's a...
I mean, did you grow up wanting to be a musician?
No, I didn't grow up wanting to be a musician, I don't think. I always knew that there was something better than working down the pit, though. You know.
This one's called Power and the Glory.
Power and the Glory.
one specially for you. It's called And the Dance. Play it on. Come on! We'll be right back.
Here tonight. I don't care if there's